Hello everyone, I'm Mukul Mantosh, a goal and developer advocate at JetBrains. Today we will have a demo session on using Kubernetes inside GoLand. Just for your information, the Kubernetes plugin comes inbuilt starting from the 2024.2 release. I'll be sharing the GitHub repo in the video description, so make sure to check it out. It will be helpful to follow along with me. Before we dive in, ensure you have a local Kubernetes cluster set up on your machine. For this tutorial, I'm using Docker Desktop with Kubernetes enabled. If you look at my screen, you'll see a simple Go web app running. It connects to a database and handles basic CRUD operations. It's pretty simple but useful. To give you a quick rundown of the Docker file, I'm using a multi-stage build for the Go app. First, I'll use the minimal Alpine image to build the app, then copy it to a distroless base image for deployment. A distroless image is super lightweight, just the app binaries and runtime dependencies without any extra OS tool or shell access. Now let's move on. I'll open the services tool window and connect to the Kubernetes cluster. If you encounter a situation where the Docker desktop is not visible, don't worry. Just go ahead and click the plus symbol to add a new cluster. You can choose from the default directory or even provide a custom kubeconfig if you want to connect to a GKE or AWS cluster. Let's begin by creating our first YAML file. We will create a Kubernetes pod to deploy an Nginx server. The nice thing about working with Kubernetes is the predefined live templates. As soon as you type K, you'll see options like namespaces, deployments, cron jobs, ingresses, and more. And if you want, you can even customize these templates to fit your needs. Now let's get back to creating the pod. Set your current cluster to Docker Desktop and apply the changes. Next, go to Workloads. And under pods, you will see the Nginx pod running. You can take various actions from here, such as viewing the YAML file, describing the resource, following or downloading logs, and even forwarding ports. Let's go ahead and forward the port to 8080. What if you want to run a command from the CLI but can't remember the exact syntax? With AI Assistant, you can do this seamlessly. Just a quick note, AI Assistant requires a subscription. Don't worry though, we offer a free trial, so definitely go ahead and check it out. You can also manage many things directly from the IDE. Like the network policies, ingress, storage, CRDs, and so on. So here is what we are going to do. We'll be deploying a full-fledged application that runs a database and a web service built with Go. Just follow along with me and we'll get through it together. We'll start by creating a namespace for the application. A namespace helps us organize and isolate resources into separate groups, each with its unique name. This comes in handy when managing different environments, so everything stays neat. Make sure to change the namespace from default to the newly created one. Next up, we'll create a database pod that will run Postgres. To keep things secure, we have already created a config map that stores the database credentials. Along with that, we have a Postgres service that the web application will use to connect to the database. We are also going to set up a persistent volume and a persistent volume claim, allocating 1 GB of storage with access mode set to read-write once. Depending on your specific use case, you may need to adjust this a bit. Finally, we'll create a deployment using a single replica of the Postgres 17 image. This will be connected to the database credentials and the persistent volume we set up earlier. And here is the cool part. You can easily navigate between label selectors defined across different files, super convenient for keeping track of everything. Alright, Let's go ahead and deploy the database now. It will take only a few seconds and we'll have the database up and running in no time. Now let's move on to deploy the Go application. We'll start by creating the config map, which holds the environment variables the application needs. Notice that the DB host is set to the Postgres service. This is the same Kubernetes service we created earlier for the database. Next, we'll create a deployment with a single replica. This will use the Docker image. It's based on the Docker file I showed you at the beginning. We have already pushed the image to Docker Hub, so it's ready to go. Then, we'll set up a service of type NodePort so we can access the application from outside the cluster. This will be exposed on port 3004. Go ahead and deploy it. You can check the logs directly from the IDE. At this point, both the application and the database should be up and running. Now it's time to test things out. But hold on, what if I told you it's not just about scrolling through the logs or using grep to identify patterns? It's actually much easier if you do it from the IDE. With features like soft wrap, the logs are much easier to read. You can download filter logs or even customize patterns to filter the data. You also have control over the log sources, which by default are set to pods, deployments, and replica sets. Filtering data by date and time is quite common, and now it's really convenient. You can even choose which log fields to display or hide. And if you want something quick and simple, just start typing to search for the relevant information directly. There is one more interesting thing I like to showcase: executing a shell inside a pod. I have used Nginx server as an example. As you can see, it feels just like working inside a remote machine. Perfect for troubleshooting or debugging. But that's not all. You can even create secrets. No need to manually encode the data. The Kubernetes plugin will handle that for you automatically. Plus, you can decode that data back into plain text when needed. Alright, now let's return to testing our application. I will make a REST API call using the POST method to try to create a new user. The application is accessible on port 3004. As you can see, we have received a successful response confirming that the application is working as expected. And that's a wrap for today's demo. We have covered how to work with Kubernetes inside GoLand, whether it is about creating pods, deploying, or troubleshooting them. I hope this gives you the confidence to work with Kubernetes on your projects. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content. Thanks for watching and happy coding.